Going to the next level in our discussion about the perils of sexual immorality. If you remember, we discussed this topic for 6 weeks, and in December we praise the Lord. And today we are in the New Testament, praise the Lord. The Old Testament laid the foundation, praise the Lord. And I can assure you that only a little difference has taken place between what was in the Old and what's in the New, praise the Lord. Because in the Old, if you committed sexual immorality, praise the Lord, I adultery or fornication, praise the Lord, with someone not your wife, you are condemned to death, you are killed, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But today, the only thing that has changed is that you won't be killed immediately, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You will be what? Charged eventually by God, by the word of God, and you will go to hell, praise the Lord. And if you're not a kid, spiritually you're healed, you will even die physically, praise the Lord. People have been treated physically, praise the Lord, because of sexual immorality, praise the Lord. Let me give you an example, for instance. The other day I was watching IMMORALITY, praise the Lord. And for the Joshua, under the anointing, praise the Lord, spoke out the word of knowledge and he called out a man. Said, there is a man here. You have killed two people already. You are about to kill the third person, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And the man came out. And then he said, where is your wife? The wife came out, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The man killed the two men with the Yoruba juju, witchcraft, or medicine called Babu, praise the Lord. Babu, praise the Lord. They went and said, another man's wife, and the spirit of death did what? Slaughter the prisoner. The top person was about to die, praise the Lord. And you know what I'm saying? Just last night I read it, a different about a young man in Lagos, praise the Lord, in two places in Lagos, who went around to have sex with foreigners, and he died right there, praise the Lord. On top of that, praise the Lord. It happens a lot. The other time you have a young girl in Lagos, a young girl who's with Lagos, who went to Lagos, okay, to meet a man in a hotel, praise the Lord. Professor Director, praise the Lord. And the first time you have to do sex and to campaign, praise the Lord. The other time you have to do they took her, they were, this was like a brother, praise the Lord. It finally they killed. Okay, it was the news about his company. You understand? Even though the case said this, God has said what? Judge us so that you shall not be judged. Condemn us so that you shall not be condemned, praise the Lord. After sentence, some people see this, it's right here when they commit sexuality, praise the Lord. But that's how they check the Lord, okay? Most people are not killed. God didn't say kill, praise the Lord. Now, but there is what? Judgment that is still awaiting, praise the Lord. And punishment, praise the Lord. That's not the word, the life that stops. Praise the Lord. But today, if I don't know, we're going to be looking at what Jesus said and what Jesus taught concerning sexual immorality, praise the Lord. Concerning what? Sexual immorality. Because you know that there are those who go around. In fact, many of the churches today, where you see pastors who are meeting with each other, a very African pastor not married, they are together having sex, and they are going to preach the book with everybody. Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! And as I'm going back to say, my brother and sister, you know, it's grace of God, Jesus has paid. We can't, we are no longer, you know, not being sweating ourselves, you know, suffering. Perhaps the pastor wants to get married. This one is not the one fast. And it is the praise God. Oh, this one is Christian, the one is what? One again, Christian, and they're living together. How is it celebrating the praise God? I see iniquity, praise the Lord. That's what? Iniquity. You don't want to destroy themselves. They believe that when that woman was touched the act of adultery and brought before Jesus, praise the Lord, and Jesus faith. That Jesus looked at the woman and said, I told them, anyone among you who doesn't commit adultery, so that came out. He was, and he began to run to the ground and said, oh, my mom, I'm not sure. Please do this. And he ran away, praise the Lord. He said, you see, woman, you see? Adultery is natural. Sex is natural. Go ahead and continue with your sex. Don't punish your mother on sex. Praise the Lord. Because that's what the believe Jesus said to the woman, praise the Lord. And to make matters worse, there are those who don't choose to praise the Lord. The second one, they say, ah, what about Mary? at the feet of Jesus. She was a bad woman. I'm sure she was a prostitute in Harlot. And she came and she poured alabaster oil at the feet of Jesus. With her hair, she wiped it off. And she said, now that I have sown my seed and my sacrifice, I'll just go out and beg more money from my prostitution. And Jesus said, it's okay. Don't if you see this fornication adultery, you do not look at nothing. Go your way and enjoy yourself. Make money from your adultery and prostitution. See what Jesus said? And that what Jesus did? This is what these wicked souls are today, and the select text in the church, want to tell us, people in the church, that Jesus did. But this is what we're going to prove, and that is not what Jesus said. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. That's not what Jesus did, but what he said. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. What Jesus thought and said about sexual immorality, praise the Lord. The very first thing that we can learn from the Master and the Creator of all universe, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He taught us that sexual immorality begins with what? For men, most of the time, it begins with what? With looking with your eyes, praise the Lord. It's not that what? You know what it does what? Begins with looking with what? Your eyes, praise the Lord. The second thing Jesus taught about sexuality is that the heart sin, praise the Lord, of immorality, praise the Lord, is equal to the physical act of putting your organs into each other, praise the Lord. Okay? Jesus taught that, praise the Lord. Don't think that you are free because you only looked at coveting another man's wife, praise the Lord. I'm glad I do that. But what? That is the same thing as actually doing it with her, practically, praise the Lord. This is what Jesus said, praise the Lord. Thirdly, Jesus taught, praise the Lord, that adultery and fornication are what? Are sins, praise the Lord. If they do this, they are what? They are sins that you and I are not supposed to commit as believers, praise the Lord. Fourthly, Jesus taught, I will show you all this from the word of God, praise the Lord. Jesus taught what? That sexual immorality is a sin that is what? Severe enough, strong enough for a man who is a Christian to say, I will no longer live with this lady, praise the Lord. Who goes around sleeping with like dogs, you know what I'm saying? With people, praise the Lord. I don't want to give her temple to go to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know what I'm saying? And that the woman has a right to say, I will not live with that man, and God will not send a person to her, praise the Lord. The Lord that man is doing that thing, but he's only going to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus comes, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That a woman has a right to say, no, I won't continue this marriage with you. A man has a right to say, what? I won't continue this marriage because your temple is totally what? Polluted, which belongs to God. And you are always bringing and attracting spirits into you that will destroy and destroy my faith. Praise the Lord. This is the message of Jesus, praise the Lord. But then Jesus also taught that as believers, we are not to practice what Balaam made Israel to practice, praise the Lord. Combining fornication and adultery as well as idolatry, praise the Lord. Jesus also taught that the church is not supposed to practice what the Creator Master and his followers, the Nicolaitans, we are practicing. We have a community of one, praise the Lord. We are a man who feels like, you know, he has a God. We just find any sister around and you just find church, praise the Lord. And say, they are all our wives, they are all our husbands, praise the Lord. The Nicolaitans, praise the Lord. And also the followers of the magician, Simon Magus, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus also taught that Christians are not supposed to do what? To involve, ladies are not supposed to get involved in what? In seduction, praise the Lord. Can you say to praise the Lord, praise the Lord? Hallelujah. And you know what? I should practice what? Just praise the Lord. That ladies, ladies, the Lord, this is the praise of God, in the church. And she was, she is what, you know, I'm sure a spirit was coming at the same spirit that was in Jezebel, in Ahab's wife, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So we look at all this today, praise the Lord. What Jesus said and what Jesus taught about sexual immorality, praise the Lord. Beginning from Matthew chapter 5, verse 27 to 28, let's go there right now. Matthew 5, 28 to 27. Matthew chapter 5, verses 27 to 28. 27 to 28. It says, 27 says, ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, thou shalt not be adopted. But I say unto you that whosoever looketh on a woman to lust after her has committed adultery with her already in his hands. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. He says what? That whosoever that looketh and said to you, that whosoever that looketh at a woman to lust after her has committed adultery with her already in his heart. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And then Pastor Ben says, if thy right eye offend thee, pluck it out and cast it from thee, for it profited from. But it is what? Profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. He goes on again. Hallelujah. Amen. And if thy right hand offend thee, cut it off and cast it from thee. For it is profitable for thee that one of thy members should perish and not that thy whole body should be cast into hell. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now this is very, very important. He says, adultery is enough to do what? To send you to hell. Praise the Lord. But if it will do what? Throw everything, praise the Lord. Throw everything that will do what? To send you to hell. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Cast it off. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now look at verse 32. I say Jesus taught what? That fornication and adultery can be a reason. Praise the Lord. Can be what? A reason. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ can be a reason for what? For separating from someone, for your body. Praise the Lord. For the absence of them. And God will not say you have sin, you will go to heaven. Praise the Lord. When you go to heaven, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. It's reason enough for you to do what? To divorce somebody and go to heaven. But reason with those who tell you that you can also, you don't have to go by force, but you don't have to go by force, praise the Lord. If you are in a marriage and you have chosen the path of righteousness to live, but to God's word, praise the Lord. As a pure and holy person, praise the Lord. But your partner insists on being what? A polluted person. The Bible says you have a right to do what? To divorce the person, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know the sign of being very spiritual, responsibility of saying to somebody who is. Usually, if you know within you, praise the Lord, that you can pause, continue to cover up that immorality, praise the Lord. It keeps destroying your soul, it keeps saddening you, it keeps making you, depressing you, praise the Lord. You have the right to do what you have, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus said, praise the Lord. Amen. Yes. Let's go there. He says, verse 31, it has been said, whosoever shall put away his wife, let him give her a writing of divorcement. And it's for any reason, praise the Lord. 32, but I say unto you, and whosoever shall put away his wife, saving for the cause of fornication. Fornication is used in a broad sense for all sexual immorality. Praise the Lord. It includes adultery. Praise the Lord. Okay? There are those who say, hey, it's a fornication. I am married. Fornication is not for many people. It's a lie from hell. This fornication covers all forms of sexual immorality. Praise the Lord. But adultery is not used in a broader sense. Praise the Lord. Like fornication. Praise the Lord. Covers sexuality. Fornication covers all manner of sexuality. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. For I say unto you, that whosoever shall put away his wife, tell you for the cause of fornication, causes her to commit adultery. Praise the Lord. And whosoever shall marry her, that is thy boss, for the water, adultery. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. He says, except for fornication, he takes what he considers fornication, which is adultery for an animal. Praise the Lord. Severe sin is not. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. For you to do what? To put away suffering. Which means one of the periods of consequences of sustainability is what? Is that some people have lost their marriage. Praise the Lord. Some preachers have been divorced by their husband. Praise the Lord. Because they went to sustainability. Praise the Lord. Not just once. Praise the Lord. Because once they would have had a. Praise the Lord. Okay? Occasionally, maybe twice. But nobody can see the word, say what? Love and trust. Praise the Lord. But if you see your happy, praise the Lord, and say they lose marriage. Okay? You should be divorced. Praise the Lord. Don't say, you should be what? Divorced. Praise the Lord. And then at once, I am a good teacher of God's word. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Some ladies have been divorced, some men have been divorced, some pastors have been divorced, praise the Lord. And so many pastors who are divorced today because of adultery, praise the Lord, give life to people, telling them all kinds of nonsense as it is, praise the Lord. But they are so immoral that their past partner was mortally wounded in the spirit, praise the Lord, because of what they did. And most of the time they come. It's like, if anyone who to let church is what is wrong with, praise the Lord. By expecting people to do what? To want to live in all kinds of sexual atrocities, praise the Lord. As Christ says, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus came to say, praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Jesus taught also that all sins, including sexual immorality, proceed from the heart. Praise the Lord. Let's look at Matthew chapter 16. Chapter 15, verses 16 to 19. Praise the Lord. Chapter 15, verses 16 to 19. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Chapter 15, verses 16 to 19. Praise the Lord. Okay. Jesus taught that what? Adultery and fornication proceed from where? From the heart. Praise the Lord. If you have not conceived it here, in your spirit, in your heart, it will not take the place of God. If your spirit has not become corrupted, you won't engage in fornication and adultery. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Matthew 15, 16 to 19. 16 is saying, and Jesus said, I also yet without understanding, do not ye understand that whosoever, such as that whatsoever entereth in the mouth, goeth into the belly, and discusses out into the draught, as into the deep. But those things which proceed out of the mouth come forth from the heart, and they defile man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, and blasphemies. Praise the Lord. He says, what? If the rat as bad as the fire, out of it to proceed water, fornication, and water, and water. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There's no question of, you know, I didn't think about it, hey, I just seen it. I mean, you know, got it? Got it? Okay. A lot of people want us to believe. They don't know why they did this. Come, they don't stop in here. As they say, praise the Lord. Okay. Hallelujah. Today, there are those who are using machines, praise the Lord. Okay? There is what? Machine, that is something called Henry J. Lewis, electromagnetic activity, praise the Lord. Wait, praise the Lord. Whether they have the machine close to where you are, they have a house where you say, praise the Lord. Or it's coming through the device, the internet, the satellite, the praise the Lord. They can stimulate you, praise the Lord, to begin to have sexual stimulation in your eyes, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay? I'm talking about the praise the Lord. That is, that is, praise the Lord. If somebody is doing that, you're not having sex, praise the Lord. Okay? Brother, a child of Satan is doing something to you, praise the Lord. You are not sinning, praise the Lord. Okay? You are not sinning because somebody is somewhere putting your body to somebody, praise the Lord. You know, that's why this body, praise the Lord, will not be saved until the rapture of the said, praise the Lord. When you will receive the glorified body, praise the Lord, with which Jesus went to heaven, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And that body, Satan will not be able to do what? To put together inside it, or squeeze it to sleep, or put sex into it, praise the Lord, or put sickness and disease into it, praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. So Jesus not from the city, we just spread water. That's our God. Come on from that, praise the Lord. You can't say we had that said that said. No, you can't be praise the Lord. No, it's not about it. You look at you will wait for the person. The person came. But the person approached you, okay? And you have the right to say no, okay? You see, but you talk about it and you say this will give me pleasure, okay? Let me see, and you went ahead and did what? And you say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Jesus said that the law of Moses, praise the Lord, which says that you should not commit adultery and fornication is for you. He applies to you to the praise the Lord. Jesus did what? He approved of the moral law, praise the Lord. The Ten Commandments, the moral law has been abolished, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's one of the things, praise the Lord, that I gave in one of our conferences, praise the Lord. Okay. Jesus said what? I did not come to do what? To abolish the law of Moses. But I came to do what? To implement or to enforce what? The moral law, the Ten Commandments, praise the Lord. It was never abolished, praise the Lord. Jesus said what? A new commandment given to you that you what? That you will love one another. Okay. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, praise the Lord. And then you shall love your neighbor as yourself, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because these two and all of the Lord and all of the prophets, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. On these two and what? All of the Lord and all of the prophets, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. Let's see where Jesus said that the law of Moses applies to you today. Praise the Lord. So there were the ceremonial laws, praise the Lord. The law of the feast. You have the feast of Tabernacles, you have the feast of Passover, you have the feast of weeks, you have the feast of ingathering, and the feast of Pentecost, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The law of the feast, praise the Lord. But Jesus said in the Testament, therefore let no man now judge you greater. He was with the new moon, with the Sabbath, or with the feast, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. So that law has been what? Abolished, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And then the sacrificial laws praise the Lord. Which involves sacrificing pigeons and often goats and bulls and goats and the plow, praise the Lord. And what the Bible says, by one sacrifice, Jesus has taught us, he has sanctified them forever. He has perfected them through one sacrifice, praise the Lord. So you don't have to sacrifice the bull and goat again, praise the Lord. But there is a law that must not have, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That law is the law. It's not about the praise the Lord. It's not the moral of praise the Lord. And Jesus says, if it was true, love the Lord with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, your strength, and only you shall be worshiped. But love your neighbor as yourself. He says, on this rule, what? All of the law and the prophets, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And now Jesus speaks to us from Matthew chapter 19, verse 18, praise the Lord. Matthew chapter 19 and verse 18. And he said unto him, which, okay, let me read it from 16. He says, and behold, one came and said unto him, good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life? And Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is no good but what? That is wrong. But if thou will enter into life, if you will be born, if you will be saved, if you will go to heaven, keep the commandments, praise the Lord. Keep what? The commandments, praise the Lord. Verse 18. He said unto him, he said unto Jesus, which commandments? And Jesus said unto him, thou shalt do no murder. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Praise the Lord. Said what? Jesus said what? Shall not commit adultery if you will enter into life. Into what? The life of God. Eternal life. Heaven, praise the Lord. Thou shalt not steal. Thou shalt not bear false witness. Honor thy father and thy mother. Okay? And thou shalt not deliver this. Praise the Lord. This is what? All these are what? The moral law. The Ten Commandments. The Ten Commandments. Praise the Lord. He says, thou shalt not what? Jesus said what? Jesus said what? Thou shalt not commit adultery. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to serve Jesus again right now. Praise the Lord. We will be serving Jesus in Galatians. In Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21. But going to mix just a little mixture of what Jesus, what Paul said, praise the Lord. Concerning entering into the kingdom. And what Jesus said, if you will enter into life, praise the Lord. If you will what? Enter into life. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Paul in Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21. Let's read it. Hallelujah. Galatians chapter 5, verses 19. Praise the Lord. Galatians chapter 5. Galatians chapter 5, verses 19 to 21. Galatians 5, 19 to 21, it says, now the works of the flesh are manifested, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, maybe things like masturbation, you know? You got it? When we're looking at many pictures, you got it? As a place to the Lord, you got it? Uncleanness, lasciviousness, always wanting to engage in things that are carnal and immoral and sexy, lasciviousness, praise the Lord. Then he says, I call it to witchcraft, hatred, various emotions, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envies, murders, drunkenness, rebellions, and such like, of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. He says, they which engage in adultery and fornication, uncleanness and lasciviousness, shall not what? Inherit the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Let's see that story now we talked about earlier, the place where they believe that Jesus told the woman, is it sex you committed? Fornication, adultery? Go on, you doesn't count it as sin, just throw your away. Anybody can fornicate that sin at any time. Look at this simple Christian. You don't care whether you are fornicating or not. Praise the Lord. Let's see what Jesus said to that woman. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
John chapter 8, verses 10 to 11. Praise the Lord. John chapter 8, verses 10 to what? To 11. John chapter 8, verses 10 to 11. And the scribes and Pharisees brought unto him a woman taken in adultery, when they had set her in the midst. They said unto her, Master, this woman was taken in adultery in the very act. And hallelujah. Now Moses in the law commanded us that such should be stoned and be stoned to death. But what sayest thou, Master? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Those who study, you know, before us, praise the Lord, told us that the reason that we are asking for this question, praise the Lord, was not to see if he was a merciful loving Savior who will help this woman, praise the Lord. Since they were trying to catch him, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The question was to catch him, praise the Lord, because he was not a magistrate in Israel and he was not a judge, praise the Lord. Okay. He was not. We don't say. But before you, we talk to God, so praise the Lord. Jesus had been there, told them what? Judge not, and you will not be judged. Condemn not, and you will not be what? Condemned. Now, why should they not have done what they did? They didn't bring the man of God to the woman, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. They didn't know what? They didn't bring the man, praise the Lord. And they themselves all had their own sins, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So we had a problem. But let's see what Jesus did. Let's see what Jesus did. He said, verse 6 says, these they said was tempting him that they might have to accuse him. But Jesus stooped down and with his finger wrote on the ground as though he had them not. So when they continued asking him, he lifted up himself and said unto them, he that is without sin among you, let him first cast a stone at her. Verse 8. And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground, and they which had it been convicted by their own conscience went out one by one, beginning at the eldest, even unto the last. And Jesus was left alone. And the woman standing in the midst, praise the Lord. Verse 10. When Jesus had lifted up himself and saw none but the woman, he said unto the woman, unto her, woman, where are those thine accusers? Has no man condemned thee? Verse 11. She said, no man, Lord. And Jesus said unto her, neither do I condemn thee. Go and see no more. Praise the Lord. What did he say to her? Go and sin no more. He said what? Go and sin no more. He said what? Go and sin no more. Praise the Lord. If fornication and adultery was not careful, would he have said to her, not do it again? No, he wouldn't have. So Jesus never told this lady. He never said what? We don't care whether it's fornication or adultery. Not a sin to God, but the other says, if you steal, let them kill you. If you be disloyal, if you lie, that's a sin. If you are proud, that's a sin. But when it comes to sex, sex is natural. So you can go. He said, what? Don't do it again. Don't do it again. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Okay, let's see again whether Jesus approves of sin. Praise the Lord. Luke 7 at the end of 15. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7, verses 38 to 50. Luke 7. 38, it says, and stood at his feet. Okay. Let's go. Praise the Lord. Amen. From verse 36. And one of the Pharisees desired him, this and that he would eat with him. And he went to the Pharisees and sat down to eat. And behold, a woman in the city, which was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at meat in the Pharisee's house, she brought an alabaster box for him. Praise the Lord. The woman, okay? The woman did what? Brought what? An alabaster box of ointment and stood at his feet behind him weeping and began to wash his feet with tears and did wipe them with her head, the hairs of her head, and kissed his feet and anointed them with ointment. Now when the Pharisee, which had bidden him, saw it, he spoke within himself, saying, this man, if he were a prophet, he would have known who and what manner of woman it is, this is, that touches him, for she is a sinner. Praise the Lord. She is what? A sinner that was touching Jesus, caressing his feet, washing his feet with her tears, anointing his feet with sweet smelling ointment. Praise the Lord. 40. And Jesus answered, saying unto him, Simon, I have somewhat to say unto thee. And he said, Master, say it. Verse 41. And there was a certain creditor which had two debtors. One owed 500 pence, and the other 50 pence. And when they had nothing to pay, he frankly forgave them both. Tell me, therefore, which of them will love him the most? Praise the Lord. Which of them will what? Will love him the most. Simon answered and said, I suppose that he to whom he forgave the most. And he said, unto him, thou hast rightly judged. Praise the Lord. To whom he forgave what? The most. And he turned to the woman and said unto Simon, seest thou this man? Are you not the that I have? And he lets me know what to wash my feet. But she has washed my feet with her tears and wiped them with the hairs of her head. That you must be noticed, but this woman, since the time I came in, hath not ceased to kiss my feet. My head with oil now is not anointed, but this woman anointed my feet with ointment. Therefore I say unto thee, her sins, which are many, are forgiven, for she loved much. But to him, little is given, to whom little is given, the same loveth little. Praise the Lord. This woman did what? This woman loved much. Praise the Lord. Because our sins, which we have much, have been forgiven. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And said to her, unto her, woman, thy sins are forgiven. And they that sat at meat with him began to themselves, who is this that forgiveth sin? And he said to the woman, thy faith hath saved thee. Go in peace. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Was this another case of Jesus seeing a woman who is an adulterer and a prostitute? And she came and poured her tears on his feet. And she washed his feet. And she felt, I'm not regretting, I have sold my sacrifice. Because I have sold my sacrifice. I'm not taking with my use of the silver. They have made me go back to my prostitution. And to make money. What did she do? Why was she weeping? And she says, what was she doing? She was? She was a sinner, and she hated her sins, and she looked at her sins, and she felt for the of her sins, and she was asking Jesus to forgive her, and she was asking God to forgive her. She had repented from her sins. She had done what? From the way of her sins was the Lord. And Jesus said, your sins are forgiven. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Did she say, I'm going to go and ask the blessing by Jesus? And the blessing by Jesus. No! If Jesus said to Christ, the first woman, God, go and send the woman again. Will he hear now this woman and say, woman, But she's not forgiving. But you are giving to the truth.
No!
Close the door.
She was saying, Master, Master, I'm dying. God is destroying my life because of my sins. Help me.
Close the door. Jesus saw her.
What?
Repentance. True repentance. And he said to that woman, your sins are forgiven. Close the door. And he knew.
It's not only the sin of immorality that Jesus forgave me, but why you want to see
praise the Lord.
Because the thief who was with him on the cross, praise the Lord, a thief, with that thief, praise the Lord, recognized him as Son of God, praise the Lord, and said, Master, please, please, I know, that a thief is cast, has no place with God, heaven, praise the Lord. But Master, please, give me money, give me money. What did Jesus say to him? You shall be with me in paradise because you have repented of your sin. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So he forgave father's sins and go for the praise of God. It was not talking about, you know, he says, talking about two people here, okay? Who we are what? Forgiving their sins. Praise the Lord. The other person who he forgave, praise the Lord. And this woman who he says loved the most because at all she was supposed to have been born at, praise the Lord. Which was not born at, praise the Lord. Spoke to them, she was not what? Healed, praise the Lord. Took for her to have life because father said, praise the Lord, the person who gives a father something, you may just do what? You may just replace it sevenfold. They may not believe. But for adultery, you may have been spoke to them, praise the Lord. I don't know. So she was forgiven of so much. Hallelujah. And I said, even if the Lord told you today, your cost already, you will soon die. Just like I was saying, praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
And it's not a bit like, praise the Lord. Because God said, what? Excuse those who praise the Lord. Okay? And maybe when he came to David, when I was in David, he looked at the Lord, praise the Lord. He postponed it to praise the Lord. But it's the sword in the back of the Lord. I don't believe I have to pay for it, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And this will have to be all that for the praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus is love. Jesus is love. Amen. We will be closing right now. But at least before we close, I will be taking something I have taught before. Yeah, praise the Lord. But it's the New Testament, but it's not from the Lord. Praise the Lord. Revelation chapter 2, verses 12 to 20. Praise the Lord. Let's go to the book of Revelation. We are looking at what Jesus said and what Jesus taught about sexual immorality. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, we are so blessed, praise the Lord, to be in this age of the church. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That we didn't just come into that age of the church, praise the Lord, when Jesus had paid for their sins and gone to heaven. But they didn't have what? Releasing to us today, praise the Lord. Because we are so blessed, praise the Lord, that in our own time, after he has gone to heaven, from heaven, praise the Lord, he spoke to Saul of Tarsus, and goes to Damascus, praise the Lord, to Damascus, the servant of the Lord, praise the Lord, and the Lord takes him out of his house, praise the Lord, and he fell down, praise the Lord. And Saul, who had been Paul, wrote on the cross, praise the Lord, to show God that Jesus is still in heaven, praise the Lord, and what is concerned about what's going on here, praise the Lord. And he will fight you if you try to do what? To stand against him. This world. Praise the Lord. The same thing to John the Beloved when he was what? Cast the isles on the island of Patmos. Praise the Lord. When they tried to kill him and they failed. Praise the Lord. But Jesus Christ was manifesting his supernatural power in him and saying, this is my servant who I love. I still think you can't kill him. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And he was what? Cast to the eye, praise the Lord. And the eye of Jesus came to the praise the Lord. In that vision. And the Lord began to speak to me, praise the Lord, about the state of the church, the seven churches, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. As a lesson to all of us,
Hallelujah. To the praise of God. And to the church, I'm telling the church, praise God. People are looking for Jesus to come again and tell them in their church, you will not commit fornication and adultery again. You don't miss a sin. But the other thing, I want to bring Jesus to come to tell a person. When you can see, you can see the number of times he talked about praise God. Okay? Because the one who was going to talk about that, the one he took somebody from heaven and see the Bible, praise God. It's also have to prepare the case to another person about it, to go and tell them about the praise God. But to go and tell America to throw away morality, praise God. And the nonsense that came from the church, praise God. Which is where they church, praise God. Hallelujah. It's not seen another person. We got it. And today we gather on God, who the Lord has told you, but you have to take my healing power to a generation. That's the praise God. You have to bring the Bible to a generation. Okay? You are to take the middle of prophecy to a generation, praise the Lord, or to my church, praise the Lord. We'll see all that. Okay? But Jesus doesn't have to tell anybody. You have to go and tell those who talk of the information.
No!
He doesn't have to. Because what? The word is your church. Praise the Lord. It's in the word already. It's in the word already. And you can be. Chapter 2, verse 12, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Of the book of Revelation. And the angel of the church in Pergamos, so the angel of the church in Pergamos, the right things say, it's he which has the sharp sword with two edges. I know thy works. We are thou dwellest. We are Satan's seat is, and thou holdest fast my name, and hast not denied my faith. Even in those days we are reading Antipas, was my faithful martyr, who was slain among you. We are Satan dwellest. But I have a few things against thee, because thou hast there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam, praise the Lord. Who taught Balaam to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to instate sacrifice unto idols, and to commit fornication, praise the Lord. So hast thou also them which hold the doctrine of the Nicolaitans, which they that he hate. 16, repent, or else I will come unto thee quickly, and I will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. Praise the Lord. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. For you that have will I give to eat of the hidden man, and will I give him a white stone, and in the stone the new name written, which no man knoweth, seven he. That's the secret is. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 18. And unto the angel of the church in Thyatira write this thing, saying the Son of God, who has his eyes like unto a flame of fire, and his feet are like the fine brass. I know thy works, and thy charity, and service, and faith, and thy patience, and thy works, and the last to be more than the first. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to instate sacrifice unto idols. Hallelujah. And I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and they that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds, and I will kill her children with death, and all the churches shall know that I am he which started the reins at the house, which and I will give unto every one of you according to your works. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says also, but unto you I say, and unto the rest in particular, as many as have not this doctrine, and which have not known the depths of Satan, as they speak, I will put upon you none or that button, but that which ye have already hold fast tonight. God praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take the time to praise the Lord. The one
is the church at Pagamos. The second is the church at Tetila Pesacon.
Hallelujah. In Pagamos, they tell us that that is ancient Turkey, President. Ancient Pagamos is the present day Turkey, President. It was a Christian nation, it was around here that they had some church, President. But the Bible says that amongst them, there are two people who are what? Sabbath, so Satan. He said that is where Satan dwells, President. Hallelujah. And because Satan dwells there, President, sexual immorality also was dwells in that place, President. They had amongst them those who did what? Who had taken the word of the word, the doctrine of what? Balaam, praise the Lord. Balaam. Comes Balaam to do what? To cast the stumbling block before the eyes of praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The Bible says, Jesus said, praise the Lord, that when you are in danger, you are in God, praise the Lord. And what? For the inner doctrine, you have what? A stumbling block before you, praise the Lord. Something that will stop you from making careful. And will stop you from doing what? From walking into what? Kingdom victory, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Something that will cut your potential short. That will stop you from being the better God called you to be. That will stop you from doing what's entering into life. That will stop you from doing what? From entering into the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So these two churches of the Lord, whether the one at Chatira or the one in Pagamos, they have one thing in common, the doctrine of devils. Devils sleep with the praise of God. Therefore, had a sit in those churches of the Lord. And many of the people who were in the church of God, they are servants of Satan, praise the Lord. We pretend to be servants of the Lord. But among them also, there are the saints of the Lord, praise the Lord, of whom the Lord Jesus Christ said what? As for those of you who are not many, the two deaths of Satan, who are not servants of Satan, what happened to me, my church, praise the Lord? I will let you know what happened from what? Of the power of God, of the God, praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We've talked about the doctrine of Banner, praise the Lord. Banner, praise the Lord, was prophet of God who lived in Moab, praise the Lord. In Moab, it is possible that Bala, as a descendant of Lot, heard about the sacrifice of Abraham, praise the Lord. Abraham sacrificed. My expectation to Jehovah, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's possible that God called, praise the Lord, when he was a Moabite, God called him as somebody that came from Lot, that actually was once connected to Abraham, who had a revelation of God, praise the Lord. He was a prophet of God, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. But he had a heart for God, praise the Lord. Initially, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So when Balak approached the first time, he said, what? I'm not going to do what? To speak against you. God told me not to do what? To speak against those people because he has blessed them. They can't be passed, praise the Lord. Okay? And when he tried to go, God warned him. God warned him. An angel stood in the way to smite him. But God put the eyes of his words and said, it was just a word of the Lord. Of his donkey, and the donkey. The donkey what? The donkey what? Open to his eyes. When the donkey opened his eyes, I'm sorry, the donkey spoke with a man's mouth. Why are you waiting for me? Can't you see the end of the very sword standing in the way? The narrow way we are passing through, straight way. To smite me. If the angel spoke to him and he saw the angel, he said, what? I would have killed you if not for this. Now, you are going to see Balak. You see, I'm going. You must know of what? You will not speak anything there except what God puts in your mind to speak about his presence. Hallelujah! And that was what he did. He spoke only what God puts in his mind. Praise the Lord. But after speaking that and knowing, he didn't stop there, praise the Lord. Balak came again to him and said, but man of God, stop to tell me, you know all this with our secrets. I'm sure if you still serve the mind of God, you know that there is a will be that if it doesn't go, we will be blessed. And he smiled and said, well, Balak, I don't have seen you this, but the God, the Son, is a holy God. He's a holy God. He destroyed two cities, Sodom and Gomorrah, because of immorality. Is that right?
they are not to defile their body. They are not to serve idols. If you can get them to begin to serve another God, and get them to begin to have sex out of their own marriage, their God will get them a cast of their God upon them, and He Himself will kill them.
But what? Tell me!
So I can kill them. Come on, listen up. He told them, get out of the people with all the supermodels, all the persons who are experiencing sex, who know how to do somebody else's magic. Get their men and begin to seduce them. Begin to seduce them. Begin to seduce them. Anywhere, display your body, let them see, you know, how beautiful and sexy you are. Use the magic on them. Let them begin to die for you in the process. Praise the Lord. And they begin to praise the Lord. And when the man began to see the spirit of sex, they say, ah, please be your help. Now, I go serve your help. Okay. You got it? Talking about that, praise the Lord. You got it? So there was no adultery. Who when they want to defeat somebody, they said they must go and be sex and sex. Praise the Lord. Okay. And some there who believe in getting people to be sexing around like they do in temple, the temple. Okay, praise the Lord. Okay, I don't know about, praise the Lord. I know. Because of that. Because that was God, it was killed 24,000 men in Israel, which Moab could never have done, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So he says, what's among you in that church, in Pergamos, we are said that dwells are those that hold on to the doctrine of man, not whatever amongst you. Okay? If they are amongst you, they must repent. They must be like rubbish. You know what I'm saying? They must what? They must be like nonsense. Praise the Lord. But the ones are going to be. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, apart from that, they have also those that have water, the doctrine of the decolleges, praise the Lord. And we said in the era that decolleges, we have a group of people who are going to church history, who we are full of ourselves. One of the deacons that we are ordained, praise the Lord, in the book of Acts, praise the Lord, in the book of Acts, praise the Lord. He was saying, Josh said that Nicholas had a pretty wife, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. You know, most of the women have pretty wives, praise the Lord. Pretty beautiful wives, praise the Lord. I don't know, somehow, the women get smart. You have to say, get smart. Because every year comes, the showering gifts goes in high place, praise the Lord. You have to say, and inviting them as in the land, you know what's happening? They are busy sex, praise the Lord. And then they are also giving their husband the freedom, praise the Lord. Driving them back to those things that are of simply the type of God, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I don't know what happened because of people that were saying, they saw him as that he was, he felt guilty that he was not his wife's support, praise the Lord. Okay. You got it? The wife was too pretty. So he was ashamed. He couldn't match up, okay? And probably he permitted that to be what? He now said, people, we are now free to do what? To sleep with who they wanted to sleep with. Praise the Lord. And he went around doing that. Praise the Lord. And before God's happening, he knew the complete of husbands and wives. Praise the Lord. He became a okay? Then, who they believe that sex was not to answer, stretching back to another person. Praise the Lord. And he said, so, church fathers argue that he was not that big for that, not that big for that, praise the Lord. But when it was even on this people, the Bible says they have what in common. They have water. Then we are free people. They believe in free sex between men and women, praise the Lord. And Jesus said what? I hate it. I hate that, praise the Lord. I hate it. I will fight against it, praise the Lord. You can't have that in the church. Any church is even that is not a church, praise the Lord. He said nonsense, praise the Lord. It's what? It's nonsense, praise the Lord. It's not a church. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Now we know Jezebel. Praise the Lord. Jezebel. Praise the Lord. Verse 20 of chapter 2. Now it's nothing I have refused against thee, because thou sufferest that woman, Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and seduce my servants to fornication and to eat this in the first of the Bible. Thank you. You see, Jezebel was what? Teaching, praise the Lord. Calling herself what? A prophetess, praise the Lord. She was a prophetess. For what to be called a prophetess, it means that she probably what? Was exhibited. She probably was seen in the realms of the spirit. Okay? Can you be a prophet? A prophet is praise the Lord without operating revelation gifts. You can't, praise the Lord. You can't be seen in that office, okay? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But in spite of this woman seeing vision, praise the Lord. Getting water, knowledge again. Can you receive this? What are the praise the Lord? She was engaging in what? Fornication and seducing pastors and evangelists and preachers to also engage in fornication. And that God was the president. And God said, I don't want her, president. I don't want her, president. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Oh, glory. Keep the Lord as we get the Lord as we get the Lord. Thank you, Father. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's important to understand that there are many places today, praise the Lord. Here they will get you. They will give you the gifts of the Holy Spirit, praise the Lord. And you are speaking in tongues, praise the Lord. And you are prophesying, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But then you notice that they are not saying talk about sexual immorality, praise the Lord. No, it's praise the Lord. They want sex, you must be sex, praise the Lord. You see? Who are they? What spirit is working in them? It's the Jezebel spirit, praise the Lord. I have heard of a faithful spirit, praise the Lord. That is called the Kundalini spirit, praise the Lord. Kundalini, praise the Lord. That you'll find in the Eastern religion, praise the Lord. Okay? A person goes to fall under the power, to manifest and pray, to speak in tongues, praise the Lord. To prophesy and to make you sick, praise the Lord. Kundalini, praise the Lord. A contrary spirit, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't be fooled in the prophetic movement by the contrary spirit, praise the Lord. That's what I'm going to do, praise the Lord. Whenever you share the abundance of revelations and abundance of vision, permission, I want to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, I want to praise the Lord. And the son is good, it's good. Jesus has done it. He gave it something to work for us to enjoy ourselves with the Lord. They have what? A contrary spirit, praise the Lord. Contamini, or some other spirit, praise the Lord. Manifesting that attention, no matter what size, powers, and wonders you see, they have infected them from praise the Lord. And he's trying to ask Jesus said, prophet was that was the devil is able to what? Do what? Manifest himself as an angel of light, praise the Lord. Therefore, if his business is able to what? To manifest themselves as faith as apostles by Jesus in the praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So we must be careful to discern. But God is weak and stop. The devil is to interfere with the Lord. But the Lord wants to be blessed Lord. And the praise the Lord. We'll stop here for today. This week, we'll continue. We'll see what the AI apostles thought about social morality, praise the Lord. And that will be the end of this series of sexual morality. The beginning of social morality, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's take our offering. And my Father, we thank you for today's word. We give you praise. We thank you.